We've got three of the hottest new RCs from Traxxas. These are all brushless powered four-wheel drive waterproof trucks designed to thrash through the terrain. But what are the differences between them and why would you choose one over the other? Well, that's exactly what we're going to examine today as we compare the Traxxas Rustler 4x4 VXL, the Traxxas Max, and the Traxxas eRevo 2.0. Traxxas offers a wide array of vehicles at different price points, sizes, and power plants. The three trucks we're looking at today are fairly new, released within the last few years, and feature some of the hottest technology that Traxxas has to offer. Additionally, these three trucks come ready to run, including the items you'll need, like the transmitter, minus the battery and battery charger that you'll have to add separately. So before we compare these trucks and dive into the differences, some of the similarities between them is that they all include Traxxas Stability Management, or TSM. TSM is basically a feature that allows the truck to counter-steer the front tires if the rear end starts getting squirrely or loose. It's a feature that works really well on loose traction conditions. All three trucks also feature the clipless body fastening, so you use a latch to install and remove the body every time, and you don't have to worry about body clips. And lastly, each truck features self-righting, so with a push of a button on the transmitter, the truck will attempt to right itself if it gets flipped on the lid. It's a feature that doesn't work 100% of the time, but when it does, it's really convenient. So those are some of the coolest and newest Traxxas features packed into each of these trucks. But let's move on. Now, a few notes about our trucks in this video. The Rustler 4x4 belongs to our customer service representative, Jonah, and he's changed a few items on the truck, like the tires. He's added the chassis protective shroud, as well as the shock socks, and then he also changed the suspension arms and the connector. The Traxxas Max belongs to A-Main, but we have changed the connector on it, and it features a different battery hold-down system that we needed to change for our 6S conversion video that we made a few months back. And then lastly, the eRevo 2.0 also belongs to A-Main Hobbies, and it's completely stock except for the changed connectors. So if you notice any of those items looking different, it's because they're not stock and we changed them. If you use a lot of different batteries and chargers like we do in here with different models, connectors, we have a lot of compatibility things that we have to work through. You can change your Traxxas connector to something else, but it does affect your Traxxas warranty, so that's something to keep in mind if you might be thinking of doing it. All right, so let's compare these trucks, and we'll start with the most obvious difference, and that is their size. Now, what's interesting is Traxxas refers to all three of these trucks as 1/10 scale. Now, that's probably true for the Rustler and the Max, but the eRevo 2.0 is considered more of an 8 scale platform. Now, here they are lined up by the rear axle. And you can see the eRevo is wider and longer than the Max, and the Max is wider and longer than the Rustler. Their sizing is almost double extra large, and large. The same holds true for their ground clearance, where the eRevo 2.0 has about 2.9 inches, the Max has 1.9 inches, and the Rustler 4x4 has just over 1 inch. But that ground clearance is proportionate to the vehicle size, but it does play a big role in how rough of terrain the vehicle can drive through. And bigger vehicles also tend to feel a bit more extreme because they are so capable in different terrains. Kind of a go anywhere, do anything feel. But another thing about bigger vehicles is that they require a bigger work surface when you need to work on them, and they also require more space for you to store them. It's a bigger vehicle, it's gonna have bigger tires you'll need to store, extra bigger parts, bigger bodies, etc. The smaller Rustler 4x4 is gonna be a lot easier when it comes time to work on it, to store it somewhere, or if you wanna transport it and take it somewhere. Looking at the weight, the Rustler 4x4 is gonna be our lightest at a little over 5 pounds. The Max comes in under 10 pounds, and then the eRevo is a little bit over 11 pounds. And the weight is pretty significant because a lighter vehicle is gonna be a whole lot easier to carry, especially if you go drive your RC somewhere far away from your full-size vehicle. If you happen to break your RC and you need to carry it all the way back with you, that's not so fun to do with a big, heavy RC. For LiPo power, the Rustler 4x4 is 2 and 3S LiPo compatible. The Max is compatible with the 3 and 4S, and then the eRevo 2.0 is 4S and 6S compatible, although it requires two batteries, so you'll need two 2Ss or two 3Ss to make it 6S. So with those two batteries, you'll probably want a dual channel battery charger that can charge both your batteries at the same time. And just like the truck, that's gonna end up taking up more space on your workbench. If you compare the top speeds, the Rustler 4x4 is capable of hitting 65 miles an hour using a 3S and after you change the gearing. The Max is capable of hitting 60 miles an hour on a 4S after you change the gearing, and the Evrevo 2.0 is capable of hitting 70 miles an hour as long as you use a 6S and after you've changed the gearing. For our run times, they're all very equal. If you use a 5,000 milliamp battery in each of these vehicles, you'll probably get about 20 to 30 minutes of runtime, give or take, because it depends on the different conditions, how hard you drive, the type of terrain you're driving in, etc. Now let's move on to the chassis designs of these trucks, where we're gonna find some big differences. One thing I wanna point out about the Rustler 4x4 and the Max is that they use a traditional stand-up shock design. But on the Evrevo 2.0, it uses an inboard cantilever shock system. This allows the Evrevo 2.0 to not only have increased suspension travel out of those shocks, but it also effectively takes the weight of the shock that normally sits high and puts it down low in the chassis, effectively lowering the center of gravity. And the Evrevo 2.0 already uses a low center of gravity chassis, so does the Rustler 4x4. But the Max uses a high center of gravity chassis, and that's why it is the tallest truck of the three. Now this is really important because a high center of gravity chassis versus a low center of gravity chassis will offer very different performance characteristics. In our case, the high center of gravity chassis in the Max will allow it to pop wheelies effortlessly with very little throttle inputs. With the Rustler 4x4 and the Evrevo 2.0, those low center of gravity chassis will not pop wheelies as effortless. They will still wheelie, but not as easily, and you'll have to be a bit harder on the throttle because the front tires just don't want to lift up as easily. Another performance characteristic between a high and low center of gravity chassis is how they corner. With a low center of gravity chassis, it tends to stay flatter in the corners with less body roll, where a high center of gravity chassis in the turns will tend to roll a bit more, and if the traction is high enough and you're going hard enough in a turn, a high center of gravity chassis will tend to cause the vehicle to roll over or traction roll. A lower center of gravity chassis tends to be more stable in really high performance, high speed, choppy terrain because the weight of the vehicle is sitting lower to the ground. The vehicle will just want to stay flat and keep its tires planted as it just kind of chops through that really rough terrain. Now, what does this all mean? Well, neither a low or a high center of gravity chassis is better. They're there to offer a different driving experience. With the Max, it not only looks the monster truck part, but it plays it too, and it is a wheelie popping machine. The Rustler 4x4 and the Evrevo 2.0, on the other hand, are more suited to be driven aggressively, where you can stay on the trigger longer, a bit harder, you can toss them into turns a bit harder, and they're gonna be a bit more stable through really high speed, choppy terrain. You could say that the low center of gravity chassis are more set up like a race truck. Now, one note about the Max is you can actually add a bit more stability to the truck if you get the optional Traxxas Wide Max suspension kit, which actually makes the truck wider so it's less prone to traction rolling and rolling over on its lid. It's a great upgrade for the Max, although you do have to purchase it separately. For durability, all three of these trucks are gonna be really durable. They do have their weak points though. On the Rustler 4x4 and on the Max, they include plastic drive shafts, which after a while, they will fail. Metal drive shafts as an upgrade for both of these trucks is a really worthy investment. On the Evrevo 2.0, it includes metal drive shafts, so that's not a worry, but the push rods for the cantilever shock system tend to break and fail. Sometimes the rod ends actually just pull out of the threads. Adding the Traxxas heavy duty push rods can be a really worthy upgrade to help stop that from happening, or adding your own custom suspension droop limiters can help prevent the suspension arms from drooping down too much and actually pulling those threads out of the rod ends. Lastly, the steering servos on all three of these trucks will eventually fail, and steering servos are also a really great investment. But other than those key areas, all three of these trucks are pretty dang durable and with the right maintenance should last many years to come. Let's talk about pricing now. We'll start with the parts. And as you can imagine, a smaller vehicle is going to be less expensive to maintain. For instance, a brand new chassis for the Rustler 4x4 is $20. A brand new chassis for the Max is $22. And a brand new chassis for the eRevo 2.0 is going to set you back $28. Need a new set of tires? Well, the Traxxas pre-mount stock tires for the Rustler 4x4 are $27. For the Max, they're $39.99. And then for the eRevo 2.0, they're also $39.99. But keep in mind, you'll need two sets to equip the truck. What about batteries? Using the Traxxas 5,000 milliamp batteries for our example, the 5,000 milliamp 3-cell for the Traxxas Rustler 4x4 is $69.99. The 5,000 milliamp 4-cell for the Max is $99.99. And then the 5,000 milliamp 3S for the eRevo 2.0 is also $69.99, but you'll need two of them, so that's about $140. What about charging those batteries? For the eRevo 2.0, you've got two batteries. You probably want to charge them both at once. That makes sense. So you're going to need the dual channel Traxxas charger. That's the EV Peak Dual, and it's $99.99. For the Max, you only need one battery charged, but it has to be the 4S compatible version, and that's the EZ Peak Live at $79.99. And then lastly, for the Rustler 4x4, the EZ Peak Plus will suit you just fine, and it's $49.99. And then lastly, the prices for the truck, starting with the least expensive, our Rustler 4x4 VXL is $399.99. The Max Monster Truck is $529.99. And then the eRevo 2.0 is $579.99. So, some things to think about when shopping for these trucks. What's your budget? There's a big difference not only in the price of the trucks, but in the batteries and then the chargers they're gonna need. The parts are the same thing. The bodies, the tires, the bigger you go, the more expensive it tends to become to maintain that vehicle. If you have the budget to allow it, then maybe this isn't such a concern and the Max or the eRevo 2.0 are probably what you're really looking at. Next, how much space do you have? Do you realistically have a big work surface to work on the eRevo 2.0, to store it, to store the charger, the two batteries, all the extra parts you may come across? The Rustler 4x4 may be a really good solution for somebody with limited space. And lastly, what kind of driving experience do you want to have? Are you more into putting the pedal to the metal and driving as hard as you can? Or do you like that big crushing monster truck look with effortless wheelies and that monster truck stance? Do you need a big capable vehicle for really rough terrain? Or will you be driving on pavement most of the time? These are all really great questions to ask yourself and examine when shopping for one of these trucks, and there is no right or wrong answer. Only what works best for you and your needs. And go have fun. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a like if you did. Hit that subscribe button for future videos and leave any questions or comments you have down below. I'm Brad from A-Main Hobbies. Thanks for watching.